Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm here at the Patea Orphanage again. And this is a very special occasion because the Rotary Ants from the convention in Bangkok came here to visit the orphanage. And I have the great pleasure to talk to the wife of the RI president, Miss Binota Banerjee. Yes,
right.
Welcome to Patea.
Thank you.
You looked at the babies already, you looked at the children already. Tell me your impression about the orphanage.
You know, this orphanage is specially very clean, which is unusually clean. And I have visited many orphanages, and many orphanages you find something, but so far I did not find any fault. Everything is like manicure, pedicure, clean, and boys are really clean. And I maybe they are giving bath twice in a day, I do not know.
But yeah, definitely they have a bath in the morning, in the evening, yes. And when they are dirty in between also. Which happens with children many times. Now, being the wife of the RI president, Rotary International president, is actually a big adventure, I believe.
It is. I go around the world with my husband and I visit many, many projects, many orphanage, many old age home, and I discover many new things. And I you know, in India we run so many hospitals, school, orphanage home, and we thought before my husband become president, I used to think we do a lot, but compared to that, I go around and see other people, new innovation, new work, that makes me more mature. And I think we are no one, we are just a passenger passing by in this world.
Yes, but actually, for especially the Rotarians and also the Rotary Ants, yes, are very good passengers by, yes, because they do a lot to help,
yes,
especially with polio.
Yes.
Now, they like to eradicate polio totally from the world, yes, which is actually that close.
Yes. You know, India is polio-free now,
yes,
and now we have three countries, Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Nigeria.
Okay.
Pakistan, 3.5 months, there is no polio. Afghanistan, 3 months, no polio. Nigeria had only one polio.
Oh.
So we are hoping this year, before the 2012 is over, maybe I keep my finger crossed, maybe there will be no polio. So
that's fantastic. It's a great success, you know. I mean, they are working since so many years on that already.
Yes.
And through the work of Rotary International, I believe it happened.
Yes.
And now tell me, you were at the convention in Bangkok, the World,
yes,
Convention in,
yeah,
Bangkok. So tell me your impression about Bangkok. Tell me your experiences in Bangkok during the convention.
You know, Thai people are very hospitable. I knew that. Thai people are hospitable. But I never knew the extent of hospitality they can give. And it was wonderful, wonderful, wonderful home hospitality committee. And one of the past director, he's quite old, maybe 80s, and in the House of Friendship, he was staying and he did not know what is the time. And by the time he realized that he found that all the buses has gone, most of the people have gone, he does not know how to go back to Shangri-La Hotel. So he asked one of the volunteers, how do I go? But this volunteer took his hand like this and his wife and took the train and bring him to the house, hotel, and said, sir, now you are safe, you can go inside. I mean, this kind of work I never seen.
Yeah, I know Thai people are very polite and very, very, very nice and trying to help. So actually we are quite lucky, we people who live here are quite lucky. Now, you are from India, but when your husband was elected to become president-elect, yes, before that, how long is it ago that you had to move to Chicago?
Officially when when he is president, incoming president, that time you get the house to live. So incoming president and president, 2 years we lived in a house, and 6 months before we lived in a hotel. So basically 2 years and a half. So you leave
already there.
Yes, and we now, leave your home and come here.
And now it goes until end of June.
June. Now only one more month, one and a half.
Yeah. Okay.
So after that we go back.
So are you looking forward to go back to India?
Oh, yes, yes, I'm ready to go. Ready to go.
I believe so. So you told me that one of your children is in Canada, one is in Australia. Are these daughters or sons?
Are they?
Are these daughters or sons in Canada? Is there a daughter or a son?
Oh, okay. My son is in Sydney and daughter is in Canada.
Uh-huh. Two children you have?
I have two children and four grandchildren.
Okay. And you don't have any children in India left?
No.
So, how the traveling goes
it
on?
It is like triangular, Sydney, Canada, India. So, I travel like this all my life.
Which means your traveling never stops?
I don't know. Now, what will happen? Our life is like that. My husband always take care of the marketing. He's a director in marketing. It's our company we started,
right.
And for that job he travels a lot, and I always travel with him.
Okay.
And even in presidentship, wherever he went, I was with him.
Okay. So that's great, actually. Thank you very much for the talk. Thank you very much for your presence here. And thank you very much for all the help and support you give to your husband as a RI president, because without the help of the family and the wife, they can't do so much. So we admire you for
that. You know, everybody says, Kalyan, you are very lucky. Your conference in Thailand, and they say we are envy because you decided to go to Thailand. We said, you know, 5 years before it has been decided that conference will be in such place, but president was not decided, so nobody knows who will be the president. But it's lucky that Kalyan was the president and Thailand was the place for the convention. And we are really grateful for Thai people. They are wonderful, wonderful. I cannot explain my feeling, how I felt that about Thai people. They are very good.
But you know, it's also the way how your aura is, how you express yourself, the way it comes back.
Yeah.
And you are a very lovely person.
Thank you very much for the talk.
Great pleasure for me to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.